This is Stan Kelly here. Okay, so we're going to do another one of these videos. And we've got another two-panel cartoon here, right? Sometimes I use a two-panel construction in my cartoons. And it shows you how things change, see, over time. It's a sophisticated cartooning technique where you show the before, you show the after. I call it the before and after, okay? It's two panels. That's enough talking shop. Now, first panel, typical American family. And at the adoption agency, they're getting a baby, they get a baby, okay? Everything looks good. Goo goo ga ga, it's a cute little baby. But look, there's something wrong with that baby. Look at that there, look at that tag from China. See? I put a little clue in the face there, in the face of the baby. You see that? How that baby, there's something not quite right about that baby. Around the eyes, you can tell there's something not quite right there. But this couple is happy. Their dream has come true, okay? But watch. Bam! We get to the next panel, okay? The dream has become a nightmare. Look at this. It's 18 years later. That baby has grown up to become a radical Chinese. He's got Mao Zedong's little red book, okay? He says, death to America. And he burns Old Glory with the fire from the matches on his birthday cake. They set out their little napkins, their plates, and their forks, and they made a beautiful cake for this boy. But no, he's a monster. He's a demon. Every cartoon gets a penciling, and I send that to my editor for approval. See, my editor, even though he's 23 years old, I have to get his approval. Even though I've been drawing cartoons 55 years, I need this editor's approval. Okay, but I take him my cartoon. He looks at it, and he says, Kelly, you can't have a Chinese like that, okay? But look, he looks Chinese. He's got a rice paddy hat. He's got a robe. His face looks Chinese. His eyes look Chinese. That's how you communicate. He's Chinese. But he says, nah, you can't do that. And I said, okay, what do you want me to do? And he said, just do something else. So the creative mind gets to work. I come up with an alternate solution. I dress him in this karate uniform, okay? And I give him a little headband. And he still looks like a scary Chinese. And he's got the fangs. And my editor said, you can't have the fangs. And I said, you gotta give me the fangs. I gotta have the fangs. Because he's not gonna be scary without those fangs. He needs to be scary for the point. You will destroy the point of the whole cartoon. You gotta give me those fangs. And he finally said, okay, you got the fangs. And there's one more thing with the title. I wanted to call the cartoon Rising Sun. Okay, because they got this baby, he grows up, they raise him like a son, okay? But he turns into a monster. But my editor, he says, no, Rising Sun, that's Japan. And I said, Japan, China, I don't see the distinction. But he says, you gotta change that. So, okay, again, the creative mind goes to work, and I change it to Deadly Imports. And who's watching him there? Who's watching him from the window? That's Lady Liberty, okay? Once in a while, I like to put Lady Liberty in my cartoon, okay? She's looking on in horror at this scene because she doesn't like what she sees. This is not an American dream, it's an American nightmare, okay? This is a nightmare. So what do I say there? I say Shanghai Surprise, okay? And that's funny, see? That's funny.